Assalamualaikum everyone, welcome back to Mr. TechFox. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to fix 100% CPU usage on Windows 10 and Windows 11 in 2024, especially when CPU interrupts takes up too much CPU and leads to laggy performance. This guide will help you boost your PC's performance and increase FPS for a smoother experience. If this video helps you, make sure to support me by subscribing to my channel. Your support motivates me to bring more valuable tutorials. Let's get started. Step 1. Open Task Manager and identify the culprit. Press Ctrl, Shift and Escape button together and it will open Task Manager. And from here, under the Processes tab, check which one is consuming the most CPU. Here you can see that OBS Studio is consuming more CPU. If system interrupts like this one or Windows Module Installer Worker shows high usage, this indicates a potential issue with drivers, updates or hardware. Alright, now step 2. We are gonna update our drivers. First of all, we have to open Device Manager. To open that, press Windows plus X together. And from here, select Device Manager. And here you will see many categories like display adapter, sound, video, and game controllers and network adapters. So from here, you can expand display adapters first. And here you will see some options. From the options, you have to update all of the drivers. So normally right-click on that and select Update Driver. Select Search Automatically for Drivers and you will see here if there's any update or not. Here you can see that the base drivers for your device are already installed. That means it's up to date. Alright. So normally you have to keep all your drivers current as outdated drivers are a major cause of high CPU usage. So normally you have to expand all of the things here and then right-click on that. And select update driver every single time. So make sure that all of the drivers of your PC are up to date. Alright, now we are gonna disable system interrupts process temporarily. So normally we have to press again Windows plus X together. So normally we have to right click on this start menu icon and we'll see the window like this. And from here, select Device Manager, expand it, and from here, you can expand any category, and if you face any kind of interruption from any driver, normally you have to select that, and select Disable Device, and select Yes. So there are so many drivers here, you have to find out that and then you have to disable that. And finally, you have to restart your PC and check if CPU usage drops or not. If it does, the issue might be with outdated or corrupt drivers. Alright, now step 4. We are gonna perform a clean boot. A clean boot helps identify if a background service or program is causing high CPU usage. So normally, we have to press on our keyboard Windows key plus R. And it will open the run window. Here we have to type msconfig. Press OK. And here you will see a new pop-up window. Select the Startup tab. After then, choose Open Task Manager. And from here, you can disable all non-essential programs. Here you can see that I have already disabled most of the programs. So first of all, I'm gonna enable one of them. And then, I'm gonna disable them. That's an example for you. You can disable all of the unnecessary apps from here. And finally, restart your system and check if the CPU usage drops. If it does, gradually re-enable each startup program to isolate the cause. Alright. Now, step 5. We're gonna check for malware or adware. Normally, we have to open the settings right now. So normally we have to click on the startup menu and click on the gear icon to select settings, and after then select update and security, and from here choose Windows security. After then choose virus and threat protection, and here we can perform a quick scan. On the other hand, if you want to perform a full scan, then normally click on scan options, and from here select full scan, and then select scan now. It will start the full scanning process. When it's completed, you will be able to find out the problem and malware on your system, and you can also delete them as well. Alright. And it will help you to remove malware and adware from your system. After then, you have to restart the system and check if the CPU uses drops or not. Alright. Now we are gonna go for step 6. We are gonna disable Windows Search and Cortana. So normally we have to open the task manager. You can press Ctrl Shift plus Escape together, or you can press right click on the taskbar and select task manager. And go to details tab, and from here you have to right click on searchui.exe or Cortana and select in task. So here you can see that Cortana is not available for my PC, so I'm not gonna do that for Cortana. Now step 7, we're gonna adjust power settings for maximum performance. So normally click on the start menu and search here power options, and you will see an option power and sleep settings. Click on that, and here select additional power settings, and from here choose high performance or ultimate performance. You have to select ultimate performance if it's available. This ensures your CPU runs at maximum speed and reduces throttling, helping to reduce CPU usage. Alright, now step 8. We are gonna fix virtual memory, I mean paging file issues. So normally we have to click on the start menu again and search here advanced system settings. Click on that, and here under performance click settings. Now go to advanced tab, and now select change. And from here, you will see two boxes here. One is initial size and another is maximum size. You have to set the initial size to 1.5x your RAM size and maximum size to 3x your RAM size. For example, if you are using a 12GB RAM, then you have to use 18,432 MB. The maximum size will be 36,864 MB. So I am using a 60GB RAM, so 1.5 times of it is about 24,000, and 3x of it is 48,000. That's the calculation. After then click on set, and then click on OK, and finally click on OK again. After making the changes, restart your system to apply the new settings. Now, step 9. We're gonna run Windows Troubleshooter for performance issues. So normally we have to click on the start menu and search here Troubleshooter. And you will see an option like Troubleshoot Settings. Open that. And from here, click on Additional Troubleshooters. And from here, you can run all of the troubleshooter step by step. And it should solve all of the problems of your PC. Alright, now we are gonna go for step 10. So we will perform system file check, I mean SFC and DISM scan, because corrupted system files can cause performance issues including high CPU usage. So first of all, we are gonna run SFC scan. Open command prompt as administrator. So normally click on the startup menu and type your CMD. Right click on that and select run as administrator. Give the permission by pressing yes. And here you have to type and press Enter to start the system file check. It will take some time. After the verification, you will see that Windows Resource Protection found corrupt files and successfully repaired them, and it will fix most of the issues of your PC. Now we are gonna run DISM tool. So normally we have to type here and finally press Enter, and it will also take some time again. This will check and repair any corruption in Windows system files. After completing the operation, you will see a notification like this: the operation completed successfully, and it will fix most of the issues. Alright, now we are gonna go for step 11. We are gonna optimize Windows update settings. Windows updates can cause temporary spikes in CPU uses. You can adjust settings to minimize this. So normally, we are gonna pause Windows updates. Normally, click on the Start menu and go to Settings, and from here choose Update and Security, and from here select Pause Updates for 7 days. It will temporarily stop updates that may be using CPU resources. And finally, click on the Troubleshoot again, and if you didn't perform any kind of troubleshooters, then you can select this Windows Update Troubleshooter and click on this Run the Troubleshooter. It will ensure there are no pending updates causing high CPU usage. Alright. Now, step 12. We are gonna check for overheating. Overheating can lead to CPU throttling, causing high CPU usage. Here's how to check for it. So normally, you have to identify the temperature of your CPU. Ensure they are within the normal range, typically below 80 degrees Celsius. Clean the dust from your fans and vents regularly to avoid overheating. If you are comfortable with hardware, consider reapplying thermal paste to your CPU to improve heat dissipation. And the last step, 13. We are gonna reset Windows. Remember that if none of the above steps resolve the issue, consider resetting Windows to fix precedent problems. To reset Windows, you have to go to Settings, and then you have to click on the Update and Security and select Recovery, and from here you can click Get Started. And from here you can reset your PC by keeping your files or by removing everything from your PC. So I normally recommend select this one, Keep My Files, and after then complete the resetting process. So normally you can select cloud download or local reinstall. Cloud download can use more than 4GB data, and your connection need to be stable for that. On the other hand, you can select local reinstall also, and after then just normally reset your PC. And I hope it will solve most of the problems and almost every problems of your PC. Alright, by following these 13 steps, you should be able to fix 100% CPU usage, system interrupts, and high CPU usage on your Windows 10 and Windows 11 PC. To check the CPU usage, normally you have to open the Task Manager by right-click on the taskbar and selecting the Task Manager, and you have to select Performance, and here you will see the CPU usage of your PC. Alright, these updates and fixes based on the latest research in 2024, these will not only help reduce CPU load but also boost your system's performance and FPS. If you find this video helpful, please like, share and subscribe to Mr. TechFox. Your support motivates me to keep creating valuable content. See you in the next video. Till then, Allah Hafiz.